Peter, thank you very much for this opportunity. I know that the communications is going in and out, but can you just tell me so far, what's the situation like in Nuku'alofa and Tagata at the moment?
In Nuku'alofa, John, there's a huge cleanup operation underway. The town has been blanketed in the thick film of volcanic dust. But look, they're making progress. The roads have been cleared. The buildings are being cleaned up. Luna Road, on the waterfront, you'll be very familiar with. A lot of rubble, a lot of rocks strewn up with the tsunami. Some damage to the buildings there, but Nuku'alofa is trying to get back to normal. It appears, John, that there was a lot of very serious damage on the west coast of Tongatapu, the western coast, the beaches there. I was actually picking up some catering from Hatapu Beach as the tsunami was coming in. I was just loading up my car and left, and I could see the tsunami coming. So that area has been hit very, very bad, and reports are still coming in on the extent of the damage.
We've heard a report this morning that the British woman that was reported firstly missing, her body has been recovered, and sadly she's passed away. Are there any other casualties that you can tell us from what you know so far, Peter?
John, look, I've had no confirmation apart from the very sad case of that individual that you mentioned. I understand, in talking to our police advisors this morning, unconfirmed reports of up to 3 fatalities, but that is not yet confirmed.
Thank you. Peter, what have you heard from the Prime Minister or the government so far? Because a lot of Tongans here in New Zealand, as well as other parts of the world, are trying to get hold of their loved ones with communications. Any updates on when that will be back up to speed?
Yes. Well, look, we were given a very good initial briefing yesterday from Deputy Prime Minister Pasifika and Minister for Foreign Affairs and Minister for Finance on obviously what is still very much an evolving situation. I think the government here has declared a state of emergency. There's obviously a priority in getting the runway cleared so that the emergency supply flight that have been offered, of course, from New Zealand and Australia can enter the country. Obviously, communications are down, and there's some urgency to try and address that issue as well. So look, a lot of demands on government, John, but they're taking trying to be very focused on what they're doing. Ministers said yesterday this is the first time they're used to dealing with tropical cyclone, a volcano, volcanic eruption, and the subsequent tsunami, a whole new challenge thrown at them. So, they're working very hard, and I will be meeting with my Australian counterpart, with Prime Minister later today, to sit down with him, and we'll find out more.
Yeah, thank you, Peter. And from your assessment so far, we're now up to day 3 now. What is Tonga needing right now? What's the urgent need right now?
Look, I think there probably is a need for some things like water testing equipment. We New Zealand has made an offer to provide assistance to Tonga in that area. We'll be seeing the Prime Minister shortly, John. Let me just get my information for you. So we're looking to provide equipment that would assist in the cleanup of all the debris, including personal protective equipment, petrol and diesel generators, relief supplies. I think there's also a desire for water testing equipment. We'll find out. There's more to come, John, as the situation evolves. And we're also working with Digicel and Spark to facilitate the transport of some satellite equipment that might help as well. So we hope, John, that there'll be a first emergency supply flight very shortly.
We're very thankful for your time, Peter, and I understand that this communication might break soon, but what message do you have for the Tongan community here in New Zealand and abroad right now? Because I know a lot of people are desperately trying to get hold of their loved ones. What message do you have for them right now?
Yeah. Well, look, John, I think the immediate message is that now that the eruption is over, there's still a lot of information to come and be received, particularly from Hapai. We hope the results of the surveillance flight yesterday by the Royal New Zealand Air Force will give some further clarity as to what has happened there. But look, here on Tonga Tapu, it's very sad that some fatalities have been reported, but most people are reported to be safe and sound.
And where are people now in terms of those who evacuated their homes? Are they at with churches or schools in terms of evacuation centres?
Look, I think some people are still in evacuation centres. Here in Tonga, here in Nuku'alofa, most people, I think, if they're able to get back into their homes, they are. I think that the numbers of people in evacuation centres would be a lot less now than would have been earlier. The situation, obviously, on the west coast, where there was a lot of destruction, I think people will still be requiring shelter and also in evacuation centres. But look, I think the message to people is here on Tonga Tapu, thankfully we were spared great loss of life. Most people are safe and now having to face a big cleanup. And taking things day by day.